In this video, we will demonstrate how to install the LCN 4040 XP door closer and perform initial adjustments. After watching this video, you will be able to locate and drill the mounting hole locations in your door and frame, install the closer and closer arm, and adjust the closer for proper operation. These are the tools you will need. The 4040 XP is a universal closer and comes with all parts necessary to install in different applications. On the hinge side, the closer can be installed on the door. This is known as pull side mount. On the non-hinge side, the closer can be installed on the door, known as push side mount, or on the frame, known as top jam mount. These mounting options have different drilling locations in the door and frame. Therefore, it is very important to ensure you have the correct closer for the opening and that you know how it should be installed. The hardware schedule is a document that describes what closer should be installed and in what configuration. Check the hardware schedule for your opening and look for any notes that might describe the installation method. Also, look on the schedule for other hardware that will be installed on the door or frame, such as a coordinator or overhead holder, as this may require a special prep template. If you cannot find a hardware schedule, contact your door hardware supplier for help. This video demonstrates how to install the 4040 XP closer on the inside of the door, push side mount with a parallel arm. For all other mounting and arm options, please see the instruction sheet. In the box, you will find the instruction sheet and template, parallel arm shoe, forearm, screw pack, closer arm, closer, and cover. Ensure the door swings freely and that any latching hardware engages easily. There should be a 1/8 inch gap on the top and sides between the door and frame. Determine the handing of the door. In this video, the door is right hand. Next, determine how far the door opens. In this video, the door opens to 180 degrees. The 4040 XP is designed to be used for doors that open from 90 to 180 degrees. If the door opens to 180 degrees, use the included paper template to locate the holes for the door and frame. If the door opens less than 180 degrees, the hole locations must be measured and marked using the dimensional information found in the installation instructions. Identify the type of hinge used to hang the door. If the door is hung with full mortise hinges or a continuous hinge, you may use the paper template. If the door is hung on swing clear hinges or pivots, contact your door hardware supplier for a special template to accommodate the different pivot point of the door in the frame. Fold and tear the template along the dotted line, separating into a piece for the shoe that will mount on the frame and a piece for the closer that will mount on the door. Identify the side of each piece that matches your door handing. Remove the adhesive backing from the door template piece. Then apply the template to the door, aligning to the frame stop and center line of the hinge, as shown. Then remove the adhesive backing from the frame template piece and apply the template to the frame, aligning to the frame stop and center line of the hinge, as shown. Center punch and drill the four hole locations on the door and five hole locations on the frame. Carefully separate the closer cover from the closer. Please note the paper sleeve on the closer body, which contains an instruction for parallel arm applications. If the closer will be installed pull side or top jam, disregard the note. To install in a parallel arm application, Screw the back check selector valve clockwise until it stops. Remove the black plastic guard and paper sleeve from the closer body. The spring power setting on the closer must be adjusted to provide proper closing force for your door. Please note, an improperly adjusted spring may result in personal injury or property damage. Measure the width of your door. Then, using the chart in the installation instructions, adjust the spring to the correct number with the 5/32 inch hex wrench to the appropriate setting based on your door width. Turn the screw until the proper number appears in the power window. The orientation of the closer body when installed on the door depends on both how it will be mounted and the handing of the door. In this video, the closer will be installed in a parallel arm mount on a right-hand door. See the instructions to determine orientation for your mounting type and handing. To attach the closer to the door in a parallel arm mount, first screw the main speed valve clockwise until it stops. Then, with the closer in proper orientation for your mounting type and handing, attach the closer arm as shown, and secure with the fastener. Rotate the arm to approximately 90 degrees. Then, while holding the closer by the arm or spring tube, secure it to the door with the four screws. Self-reaming, self-tapping screws are provided as standard. Depending on your application, your supplier may have also provided wood screws or through bolts and machine screws. We recommend using wood screws for wood doors. If a power tool will be used, lower the clutch setting to avoid over-tightening, which may strip the threads in the door or frame. Then turn the main speed valve counterclockwise 1 1/2 turns and observe the arm return to the parallel position. Attach the parallel arm shoe to the frame with the five screws. Please note, for the application in this video, a spacer must be used with the shoe in order to clear the stop. This spacer is ordered separately. Depending on your frame dimension, you may need to use the included spacer with the fifth screw. If you are unable to accommodate the fifth screw, contact customer care. Attach the forearm to the shoe and secure with the two fasteners. For a parallel arm installation, position the longer side away from the hinges as shown. Slide the closer arm tube over the forearm rod and thread the arm screw through the tube and into the rod. Do not tighten the screw yet. Position the arm until it is parallel to the face of the door, then tighten the arm screw. Making adjustments to the closer allows you to control the motion of your door. There are three adjustments. Back check. Main speed, and latch speed. The closer comes from the factory adjusted for a typical opening. Your closer may need additional adjustments depending on your installation requirements. Before making any adjustments, cycle the door twice to observe its operation. The closer body has a label with adjustment information and a QR code that, when scanned, displays a web page with digital instructions and other useful resources. Please note, do not back out the adjustment screws too far. If you are close to backing out the screw completely, you should feel increased resistance. Once you feel this resistance, do not back out the screw any further. As you turn an adjustment screw, the green ring around each screw will be more visible as the adjustment is increased, and less visible as the adjustment is decreased. Back check is the adjustment that slows the door as it opens. It starts to take effect at about 70 degrees. The door will slow down to reduce the wear on the door, wall, and hinges. Back check does not serve as a door stop. To adjust it, locate the back check screw, which is the screw closest to the spring tube. For more back check, turn the screw 1/4 turn clockwise and cycle the door twice to test. For less back check, turn the screw 1/4 turn counterclockwise and test. The next two adjustments are main speed and latch speed. The main speed controls the speed of the door as it closes from fully open to about 20 degrees. The latch speed is the speed at which the door closes during the last 20 degrees. The goal for these two adjustments is to allow the door to close quickly but quietly. The door should latch but not slam. Locate the main speed screw, which is closest to the pinion, where the arm is attached to the body. Make an adjustment 1/4 turn at a time, counterclockwise to increase speed, and clockwise to decrease speed. Then open the door and release it to observe the closing speed. Latch speed helps ensure the door latches properly. We recommend only small adjustments to latch speed. The latch speed screw is adjacent to the main speed screw. Make an adjustment 1/4 turn at a time, counterclockwise to increase speed and clockwise to decrease speed. Then open the door all the way and release it to observe the latching speed. If the door still will not latch, increasing the spring power half a number at a time can provide additional closing force. However, increasing the spring power will require more force to open the door. To complete the installation, push the cover over the closer until it snaps into place. If the clip needs to be moved to accommodate the pinion, remove it gently by prying the tab and sliding out. For assistance, contact customer care at 877-671-7011.